One of the most iconic songs of the 90s.
You're striving to make something. Every time you go in the studio, half as good as a record like that. It's the Mona Lisa.
It was actually the music video for Freedom 90 that marked a career highlight for George Michael.
George pitched it to me in L.A. in a nightclub called Roxbury's. And his exact words were, "You're the leader of the gang, and unless you say yes, the rest of the girls won't."
The story of how five supermodels came to lip-sync the hit told in the new Showtime documentary, George Michael, Freedom.
Now you look like you're actually singing it. Can you act like you're singing along to it? When I had just learned it, I was like, oh my God, let's just have fun. And that's what it ended up being, fun.
Baby!
Chock full of interviews with celebrities who knew and loved him.
He is God's gift to the world.
The film covers his life and career, made before his untimely death from natural causes last Christmas at age 53.
I'm aware of the need for a persona, and my actual persona I'm not really prepared to give.
The notoriously private star co-directed with his lifelong friend and songwriter, David Austin.
Would he have been here promoting this movie?
No.
No.
He made the film, he edited the film, and he narrated the film, and that's about as far as he got. I mean, he was one person that he just didn't. Celebrity wasn't for him.
The project was intended to be released alongside the 25-year anniversary reissue of George's second solo album, Listen Without Prejudice, which he famously refused to promote. The track Freedom 90 from that album, a symbolic line in the sand for George.
With the burning of his jacket and the significance of it, and it had a lot to say.
I got the impression of saying, like, that chapter's closed, like, I'm done being a public figure pop star, like, I just want to make music that I love.
His exit from the limelight would lead to a highly publicized battle with his record label, Sony.
George Michael is today asking a high court judge to declare his recording contract null and void.
I think he was very honest about his court case with Sony, which he had never spoken about before, you know, and there's a massive reveal in it that he, you know, he says he wished he'd never done it. You know, wish he'd never gone to court with Sony in the first place.
I will never know if Sony and I would have ended up in court had Anselmo not become ill.
Anselmo Filippa was one of George's few true loves, learning just months into their relationship that he was HIV positive.
The front of this 160,000 people, there was this guy over on the right-hand side of the stage that just fixed me with this look, and he was so cute. I was so distracted by him that I stayed away from that end of the stage for a while. The moment I looked at him, I got the feeling that told me I was going to know him very well and that he was going to be a part of my life. Somebody to...
His 1992 performance of Queen's Somebody to Love, sung to honor lead singer Freddie Mercury, who died from AIDS-related complications, also a tribute to Anselmo.
Anselmo was the first time I think I really loved someone selflessly.
Anselmo passed away the following year, 1993, and George's beloved mother would follow in 1997.
How important was his pain to his success?
He says in the film that, you know, back in the day, that the grief that he felt having lost his mother and having lost his partner, I think he felt that he would, like, for example, Older was an album that followed Listen Without Prejudice. He openly says that, you know, without having felt that kind of pain, he would never have been able to have made an album like Older. Don't you think I'm
looking older? The Showtime documentary also looks at the questions of race and music raised by George's work after his debut album, Faith.
George Michael!
Won in soul and R&B categories at the American Music Awards.
I've been a lover of soul music since I was a kid.
He picked up these two awards in categories that were traditionally for black artists. And you know the problem with our industry, they do love to pigeonhole people.
He uniquely achieved recognition on the R&B soul charts that very few white performers ever got.
I don't think there's any attempt to kind of steal black heritage in what I'm doing. All I think that's happening is I'm trying to make good music.
That iconic album will be reissued today. For a new generation of fans, George's music is his enduring legacy. In a rare interview with ABC News in 2008, George Michael shared his view that fame and beauty are fleeting, keenly aware his time here would someday end.
I don't inhale any of that. It's dangerous, because what I really am is a writer. I never thought the looks were much to begin with, but whatever they are, they'll fade. You know, my brain will go. Eventually, it's all gone, but the songs are still there.
Songs like his classic ballad, Father Figure. For Nightline, I'm TJ Holmes in New York.